Celebration with them, but also for all the support you've shown them in the years leading up to this happy occasion. But as they commit themselves to one another in marriage this morning, I would challenge each of you to make a commitment as well, commitment to continue to support them in the years to come. As we all know, life is a wonderful adventure, but because it is an adventure, it will have moments of great joy, but also great challenge. Therefore, I would challenge each of you to be there to share their joys and celebrations as you are today, but also commit yourself to encouraging them in times of challenge. As they proclaim their love for each other, may each of you proclaim your love for them. Who presents Amie to be married to? Thank you, sir. Our reading is called The Art of Marriage. The little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue for all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in an attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have the wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the Spirit. It is a common search for the good, for the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It's not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. Amie and Sunil, today is a day of celebration. We have the opportunity to celebrate the love that you have for each other, and we celebrate the past that has brought you together and nurtured you as a couple. Since your first meeting, your journey together has been leading to this day. You've gotten to know each other, grown to appreciate each other. You've supported each other as you work towards your life goals. And in that process, you've committed yourself to each other. So we join with you this morning in celebrating that journey. We celebrate your present, as today you formalize that commitment you've already made. I'm sure today is a day of joy not only for you, but all of your family and friends who have watched this relationship grow and your love for each other deepen. And we thank you for letting us be a part of the biggest day of your life. But as important as it is that we celebrate your past and your present, the most important thing we do today is celebrate your future. As the writer Saint Exupéry said, love does not consist in gazing at each other, but in looking outward in the same direction. Today you look outward to a shared future, and today you embrace that future together. In this ceremony, you're committing the most precious possession you have, your life, to be shared with each other. For marriage is more than a commitment of love, it is a commitment of your life to the one that you love. As Montaigne reminds us, if there is such a thing as a good marriage, it is because it resembles friendship. The emotion of love, wonderful as it is, can ebb and flow based on the experiences of the moment. But the commitment to always be each other's best friend is what keeps a couple together and gives the love time to rekindle. So today, as two people in love, but also as friends, you commit to always being there to share the journey of life with each other. With that in mind, I will now ask you to declare your intent to be married to each other through the affirmation of the vows. But as you do so, remember these are not just sentimental declarations. They are a pledge you are making to each other. These vows must be lived out daily in how you treat each other. As important as it is, you declare them this morning, more important that you declare them daily in how you live and treat each other. I'm going to ask you to face each other with your hands, if you would. So now we begin with you. Deep breath. Please repeat after me. I, Sunil, take you, Amie.
I, Sunil, take you, Amie.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To respect and to honor.
To respect and to honor.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As we share life's journey.
As we share life's journey.
And as you present your ring to Amie, please repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge myself to you.
I pledge myself to you.
Would you repeat these vows also? I, Amie, take you, Sunil.
I, Amie, take you, Sunil.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health. To respect and to honor.
Respect and to honor.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As we share life's journey.
As we share life's journey.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge myself to you.
I pledge myself to you.
As you continue holding hands. Through the centuries, we have used rings to signify and seal covenant relationships. As you wear these rings, they are a declaration. You all can see them on your hand. You're in a committed relationship with your spouse. As you see them on your own hand, may they serve as a reminder of the necessity of living out the pledge you've just made to each other. My friends, we have witnessed the declaration of the vows of marriage and witnessed the giving and receiving of the rings of marriage. Therefore, being assured of the voluntary willingness of this couple to enter into this relationship and knowing of no legal barrier to their union, it's my great honor on behalf of the state of North Carolina to pronounce them husband and wife. May kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege to present you for the first time as a married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Sunil Cherukardi. Congratulations.